table tennis, the first thing you do, of course, is serve. And one cool thing about table tennis, you don't actually need to use any buttons if you don't want to. You can hit the T button to toss the ball up and then swing. Or if you've been playing for a while, sometimes it's better for more advanced players just to kind of flick the controller up like this and hit the ball like that. Now, once I've got a ball in rally, you'll be able to see that follow up my every movement that I do in real life. So I can, you know, turn my wrist. You can see the paddle move. I can lean forward or step back, and the paddle's gonna follow that in Z-axis, which really provides an extra added depth to the game. I can do a nice smash shot if she gives it to me, or I can do spin shots. However you hold the move controller is how it's gonna work. If you use a pin grip underneath, you'll see that the paddle here is emulating that movement. You really have control of where you put the ball. I can try to hit a near court shot or a far court shot. And it really feels like the ball is going where you expect it to go. If you want to do something kind of dumb, like try to knife the ball like this, you can try. It's going to be kind of difficult, but you know, obviously that's not a very winning technique in real table tennis. That also applies here. Say you don't want to play the progression mode, or you don't want to play multiplayer, you can go down here and choose the challenge mode. And the challenge mode are little mini games that utilize the same gameplay mechanics of the normal game, but in a new kind of fun, interesting, arcadey way. So for the table tennis one, you're actually being served balls by this serve bot, this robot, and the object is to hit the balls back into the robot for a higher score. There's an online leaderboard system which we support that allows you to compare your scores against people on PlayStation Network or your friends or whomever. All right, so what you're looking at here is the multiplayer version of table tennis for Sports Champions. So it uses the same mechanics, of course, as single player, but allows for cool, fun play with your friends or family. So in table tennis for Sports Champions, like the rest of the events, there's a pretty cool handicapping system that allows a real seasoned, experienced player to adjust their settings so that it's a more equal experience against someone who hasn't played for as long. So for example, when you set up the game, if you've been playing the game for a really long time, you can set up to, you know, the gold difficulty setting, which is going to make the paddle have less assistance as you're playing, and maybe your little brother or friend who isn't familiar with the game as much might select bronze difficulty, where there's going to be additional paddle assistance to help keep the ball in play. I'm Jeremy Ray, I'm the producer for Sports Champions. That was Table Tennis, and thank you for your time. Hope you enjoy the rest of the videos.